Now, this is an exciting one. The brand new out-of-the-box Prime Z270 A from Asus. When opening the box, you are not going to find anything special right away. The I/O shield is here, the connector bridge, some cables, our M.2 screws and screw holders, the manual, and the CPU handler. This is my very first Z270 chipset motherboard, and boy am I excited! Alright, let's take a closer look. We have 4 single-speed PCI Express on this board, and I'm still wondering why so many of them. But alright, they are here. Now we are going to take a look at the 3 40 lanes PCI Express slot. Keep in mind that they can all run up to 16 speed if used individually. And keep in mind that if you have to use 2 of them, they will be sharing their bandwidths. Therefore, they will be running up to 8 speed individually. Simply said, if you have only one video card, you can run it up to 16 speed if you use any of the PCI slot, and if you decide to go for a dual video card configuration, say connected with a SLI bridge, then both video cards will be capped at an 8 speed PCI bus. If this is your first build, in red you will see where we are going to connect our electrical outlet to the motherboard. On top, an ATX 24 pin to power the whole circuit, and on your left, an 8 pin CPU connector which will provide dedicated voltage to our processor. This is our LGA 1151 socket processor, and this is where we are going to sit our never yet benchmarked 7th generation Kaby Lake Intel processor. Very, very excited about this one. Alright, here is seemingly a boring topic, our usual dual channel DDR4 RAM modules, but on this particular motherboard it gets very exciting. Asus came up with something they call T-topology, and they claim that this will enable your RAM to run to a crazy frequency of 3866 MHz. And trust me when I say I am not going to take their word for it, we are going to benchmark the hell out of this machine. Picture this. A dual M.2 solid state drive channel on the same motherboard. When I first did my research about this board, it didn't come up right to my attention, but when I received it and took a look at the documentation, my oh my, did I light up. Now that's not the only thing. This board actually comes with a new Intel Optane technology, meaning that we can potentially run those sticks up to 32 gigabit per second. Yeah, I'll repeat that, 32 gigabits per second. And if that's true, then it really takes the M.2 solid state drive technology to a whole new level. Alright, time to take a look at the peripherals of our motherboard. A triple display output, DVI / HDMI / DisplayPort. Very nice to know, but completely useless for our configuration. As you already know, we will be using a GTX 1070 Strix to output our 4Ks on this build. Also worth knowing, we have a couple of 3.1 USBs, Type A and Type C. Before installing the motherboard onto the computer's chassis, please take the time to remove every remaining plastic on the motherboard. Alright, so what we can see on the chassis floor are the 9 screw razors which will support the motherboard. On the right bottom side of your screen you will see the side camera, which will allow us to take a better look on how to install the I/O shield and a side view of our motherboard's peripherals. To put the I/O shield in place, no screws are needed. Just make sure that our 6 audio jacks opening on the I/O shield point towards the power supply unit. Then simply apply slight pressure on the corners of our I/O shield and it should pop in right into place. time to install our motherboard. Align the motherboard peripherals with the I/O shield, and once done, rest the motherboard onto the 9 screw raisers. And those screw raisers should be able to stabilize our motherboard in place so that we can secure it with the 8 provided screws. Make sure not to over-tight our screws. Finger tight is quite enough. Oh.